I know, when you're thinking about a tajine, you're gonna say, no, 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 it is gonna be too hard. I can assure you, when you make that dish at home, it's gonna be hassle-free and super simple. Hello, beautiful people! Today, we are gonna make the most popular dish in Morocco, lamb tajine. The lamb is gonna be super soft with lots of beautiful aromatics. The flavor is sweet and savory in the same time. Ay, 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 ay. The prunes are caramelized with a cinnamon touch. I'm sure you're still waiting to make this beautiful lamb tajine. You guys are ready? Let's go! On my last vlog, I have visited a Moroccan restaurant and I had the lamb tajine over there. The lamb was very tender. I absolutely loved it. Well, today I am gonna teach you how to make that dish. And by the way, if you wanna watch this vlog, you can find the link in the description below. People think sometimes that making this lamb tajine could be very difficult. Well, I'm gonna tell you something. Follow my step and you're gonna see how super simple this dish is. Before we start, we require one important braising pot. I'm sure you can find it somewhere in your kitchen. The braising pot will basically maintain the heat and helps you cook the tajine without burning it. First, we're gonna segment the recipe into two categories. First of all, how to make the tajine, and second of all, how to make the caramelized prunes. To make this beautiful, exquisite lamb with lots of aromatics, we require olive oil, finely chopped onions. We're gonna require a lot of onions, and it's very essential because this is what is gonna make the sauce more thick. Chopped garlic, grated ginger. Ras el Hanout is a very famous Moroccan spices. You can find it in a lot of shops. White pepper, salt, turmeric, gonna give it a beautiful color. The lamb shank. It's very important to make incisions inside the lamb shank because this will help it to cook faster. If you couldn't find lamb shank in the market, you can easily ask your butcher for a beef that could be used for braising purposes, for example, like the short ribs. The bay leaf and cinnamon sticks. The saffron as well, gonna give it a small touch of flavor and as well a beautiful color. To make this beautiful soft prunes, which is gonna give it a lot of sweetness, we need unsalted butter, the cinnamon, the honey, and the apricots as well. And to finalize the dish, we require a bit of crispiness. We're gonna add the fried almonds and the sesame seeds on the top. The most important ingredient in any dish that you make is basically fun and passion, and don't ever forget that. I'm sure you're still waiting to make this beautiful lamb tajine. You guys are ready? Let's go! In a braising pot on a low heat, first of all, we're gonna pour in the olive oil. We're gonna add the finely chopped onions, the finely chopped garlic, the grated ginger. We're gonna stir all the combination until the mixture softens. It's gonna take around 5 to 6 minutes approximately. Now we're gonna add all the flavors. We're gonna add the ras el hanout, the white pepper, the salt, the turmeric. And now we're gonna stir it again and we're gonna start smelling a lot of beautiful flavors and aromatics as well. Once it's done, we're gonna add the lamb. We're gonna cook it a little bit, around 4 to 5 minutes. Then we need to add enough water. Basically, the water has to cover the lamb. We're gonna add the bay leaves, the cinnamon sticks, the saffron. Then we're gonna mix the entire combination. We're gonna let it simmer. The most important thing that you require is patience, and you have to be patient, and patience, because it is gonna take 2 hours to 2.5 hours, because this will help the meat to absorb all the flavors and to braise on a low heat, so it could be extremely soft. After half an hour, open the pot, and sometimes it requires to add a bit of water. Don't be shy, add water, but don't add too much because you want the sauce to thicken. To make this beautiful mixture of caramelized prunes and apricots, at first, we are gonna soak the prunes in hot water for at least 2 hours. Once it's done, in a pan on a low heat, we're gonna add the butter. Here we're gonna add the lamb broth that we did basically. We're gonna add the cinnamon, the honey, and the apricots as well. We're gonna let it simmer for around 15 to 20 minutes, half an hour, it really depends, on a low heat, because we want the sauce to thicken. Very similar to a syrup texture. Don't forget, the most important thing in cooking, you have to add your personal touch, because this will change everything. Now, in another pan, we can add a bit of olive oil. We're gonna add the almonds. We're gonna fry them until we have a golden, crispy texture. Once the lamb is braised, it's ready to be served. First of all, in a plate, we're gonna add the lamb shank. We're gonna top it with the braising sauce that we did. We're gonna pour in the caramelized sweet sauce, the prunes, the apricots, and we're gonna finalize it with a touch of sesame seeds. Every time I make a recipe, at the end, I always sit and explain and talk about the dish. This is not because I want to show off, to be honest with you. The secret for any dish is basically to understand the flavor and the texture of the dish. Let's try this wonderful Moroccan tajine. Oh my God, I can eat this dish day and night, to be honest with you. The lamb shank is extremely soft. The entire aromatics are well balanced, beautifully done. You can really feel the saffron, the ginger, and all the aromatics that we place in that dish. They're not really strong as a flavor. You can really feel them here. And I really love the texture of the prunes and the apricots, they are extremely soft and they melt in your mouth once you eat them. And it gave it a certain sweetness, not too strong, moderated.